Well, I mean, just want to begin by saying, who the hell are the Prakash Karats to talk like this about the army? It's been going on. Now, we could have seen, considered it to be an aberration on day one and day two and day three and day four. But now it's been almost 2 weeks. And for 2 weeks now, the only purpose of the left, if you can call it that, because I think this is a reactionary group that calls itself the CPIM. The only purpose of the left parties, along with a bunch of people who I call the pseudos, is to somehow attack the Indian Army. Abuse the Indian Army, attack the Indian Army. Make all kinds of comparisons about the Indian Army Chief. Compare the Indian Army Chief to General Dyer, get away with it, and then they say it's intellectual. Pontificate about everything and anything at every point of time. But use the opportunity to build a sentiment in this country against the Indian Army. Who would do that? And why would anybody do that? And what would be the intention behind doing that? That's debate number one. I'd like to welcome into the debate to my left, Professor Rizwan Kesar, Department of History and Culture at Jamia Millia Islamia. To his left is Amir Haider Zaidi, spokesperson of the Communist Party of India, and Dr. Taslim Ahmad Rahmani, president of the Muslim Political Council of India. So we have strong speakers on the left side. And on my right today, we have with us, to my right, GVL Narasimha Rao, national spokesperson of the BJP. To his right, Rakesh Sinha of the RSS. To his right, Republic TV's editorial advisor, Major Gaurav Arya. And to his right is RSN Singh, foremost strategic affairs expert of the country. Thank you very much. I'd like to open this debate by saying this, that Prakash Karat, who has never fought an election in his life, and whose only achievement in the context of pontificating in ink was winning one post-high school All-India essay competition on the Tokyo Olympics. That same man has written a 394-word editorial titled Damaging, and that's Fuad Haleem. That's Fuad Haleem. Titled Damaging the Army's Image on a CPIM blog website called People's Democracy. Now, let me put it in context, Fuad Haleem, and I'll start with you. The left is so desperate today for attention that its former general secretary has scribbled out his anti-India, anti-army, baseless and unsubstantiated rhetoric on a website that nobody reads. And the irony is that Mr. Karat claims to represent the Communist Party of India. Instead, he's speaking on behalf of the Pakistani armed forces by batting for their terror proxies in the valley. Simple question, Fuad Haleem, is why has it become a habit today for the left to abuse the Indian Army? What do you gain? Everyone wants to know, what do you gain by abusing the Indian Army? The debate is open and then anyone can come in. Fuad Haleem, but Fuad, I want to tell you, keep your response short. This is not a speech. I'd like you to respond, but you'll have to stop within a minute so everyone else can come in. Thank you, Fuad.
If you want me to be silent, I'll be silent also, Arnab. I'm kind that you're allowing me a minute. Now, let's be very clear that there is no way in our editorial or nowhere the party has abused the Indian Army. But we have certainly very categorically articulated certain very concrete concerns.
It has.
We are concerned that the chief of the Indian Army has used certain words like asking people to take up bullets, it's unfortunate and it's something that doesn't behove the stature of
what about history? Let him complete a minute.
I am just telling you that the chief of Indian Army has asked for people to take up bullets, which I think so doesn't behove the chief of the Indian Army. It's an unfortunate comment that he has made. And these departures from the glorious tradition of the Indian Army is going to be detrimental to the reputation of the Indian Army.